First of all, thank you, Eugene, for inviting us here. As Eugene mentioned, we're a company around cancer. Unfortunately, there's about one out of three people that will deal at one point in their life with cancer. So it's really something that is really present. Everyone knows someone with cancer. At the same time, we also know that there are a lot of advances. Advances from the biotechnical side, so there are new medications being tested with success, but also more and more knowledge about what is the impact of your lifestyle on your treatment outcome. So if you look to the cancer patient, there's about 60% who experience a kind of social isolation. They feel alone in their disease. At the same time, we also see that more and more patients, they go towards the social media to see, is there someone else in the world having the same type of mutation who has a similar history, and how does this person or did this person respond on the treatment? And then this patient can go to his physician saying, hey, could I test this medication? And there are several successes, actually, where people save their own lives because they are very proactive. And this is what we try to do here with Esperity. We'd like to make sure that patients have all the available means to them as much as possible to see what the availabilities are there for treatments for them. So we launched Esperity about a year ago. So it's a multilingual platform for cancer patients and caregivers, also focusing on improving the quality of life of patients. Now, going back to the pharma industry, so the patients, they get a certain treatment, the diagnosis, they get a certain treatment, but then they can also ask, okay, is this really the right treatment for me? We see, for example, that patients more and more go on the internet, they search, okay, what kind of clinical trial is there, and this is actually what we integrated into this platform, helping the patient to find the availabilities of clinical trials out there, and also assisting the pharma companies at recruiting these patients. So the platform that we have built is actually a really holistic platform where we try to plug in the patient's perspective and the caregiver perspective and the pharma perspective. So the first time a patient logs in on the platform, there's the social aspect. It's, you can compare it like a wall, actually, where patients can comment or post different stories. Or they can actually scroll through, like we call the wall of stories. So it's actually a collection of user stories. And if you don't speak German, it's very easy. You hit the translation button and automatically you translate to English, if you speak English. So this way you really try to connect the globe at the end. This is our wish, to make sure that you know what is the best treatment for me, even if it's on the other side of the globe. Now, what is also important, more and more there are indications that having a proactive lifestyle can actually benefit your outcome. So for example, if you sleep well, if you have a significant level of physical activity, you eat the right diet, you have the right diet, don't smoke, reduce your alcohol, you can actually cope much better with certain side effects. And this is what we try to do here, is to really empower patients to become aware how do you have to take care of your nutrition, how do you have to take care of physical activity, and how can you reduce stress. And so in this case, actually, we integrated with the Fitbit. So here, for example, today wasn't that good, 16 minutes. what we are trying to do here is actually make sure we can collect as much as objective data, combine it with subjective data, to come up with a kind of a health report. So all this data, you can also visualize over time, so you can detect trends. So trends from, for example, side effects you report, is it fatigue, is it appetite, loss of appetite, your weight, for example here. The upper graph, you see quality of life for appetite versus lower weight. So this information you can use to discover patterns, detect your physician, and also to become more empowered about the importance of lifestyle on your treatment outcome. So at the same time, you can also schedule medications, you can get reminders about consultations, and you can also visualize all of this over time. So at the end, it's the same as the quality of life indicators. And this is actually very important. Also, for example, if you go to the pharma, what are they interested in is to see what type of treatment works for what type of population. And can we make clusters at the end? So another important one is the clinical trial module that I mentioned. So here, for example, you can actually search, let's say, breast cancer in the United States. Search. So here we actually pull out the data from clinicaltrial.gov. which is a collection of all the different open clinical trials. And then the patient can actually scroll through all this data, or all these reports. They can read this, take this to their physician, and if they're interested, they actually just click, I'm interested. They fill in this form, it comes to us, and we really assist the patient to go to the PI or the recruitment center for their trial. So now we are here in the US because we are actually looking to expand. So we're based in Belgium. We have 5,000 users now, but we'd really like to grow much farther. So of course, in Europe, you have all the barriers, actually similar to the previous presenter, where it's quite limited in terms of scalability, but at the end, it's also a very nice opportunity because most of the platforms here are in English. They don't exist in Spanish, they don't exist in French, and this is where it can fit in. So if you have connections in this field, I'm happy to talk to you. And at the end, we also look for seed investors as well. So I'm happy to talk to anyone that has connections in this field as well. Thank you.
I have a couple of questions. So, first question is, when you have a patient who is undergoing treatment and they're trying to input their symptoms, they're trying to input all of these things, number one, how easy is it for them to use? Can they use a mobile device? Can they use a platform? How simple do you make it? Because when they're symptomatic, it's really difficult, right, to go through all of those steps.
Absolutely. So what we actually, so now it's a responsive site, so we don't have the native app yet, but we're working on this.
Okay.
But what we did actually through the whole development period is do workshops with patients to make sure that this is as easy as possible. We had a lot of iterations actually before it was accepted by the patients.
Okay. And can their doctors, can they communicate with their physicians and so forth, so they can they cross-communicate on the same site?
Yeah. So this is actually a project that we're working on with a hospital in Belgium currently. So we're developing the access for physicians that they can see the evolution of certain parameters over time. And also to make sure there's transparency of data about, okay, what treatment are you on, what is your history? So there's actually really no mistake, because often it's true that if you go to a nutritionist in the same hospital, you go to a kidney, you go to your oncologist, they don't always see everything. And with this platform, and this is the demand of the hospital, they would like to improve the service of what they can offer and improve the quality of care.
Okay.
So we're also now discussing with one of the major hospitals here in San Francisco, actually, where they have now certain cards actually comparable like this. So when a patient goes out,
yes,
they give like, okay, this is your diagnosis, these are your list of treatments that you got, these are the exams that are scheduled. What we're actually working on is now to import this. So the patient goes home and automatically they get the reminders, okay, in 3 months these are the exams that you have to do. And in the meantime, they can actually fill out their quality of life questionnaires, for example. So this can be used as a quality measure by the hospital as well. Okay.
So just curious, how do you ensure that the information in the platform is of a certain standard and quality for the patients?
Yeah.
Mitch, could you repeat the question just in case you didn't hear?
Yeah, so how can you make sure that the data, the quality is, or the, can you repeat the exact
just
wording?
Curious, how do you make sure that the quality of information in the platform is accurate and is of...
So how can you make sure that the quality is accurate? So actually what we do here in the system, we use certain ontologies, certain methods as well, or like for example the lifestyle, like we can calculate the lifestyle score. This is based on officially validated methods which are published. So we really have a scientific approach of calculating certain scores. Also the way you enter side effects, this is called as a VAS scale actually, these are all accepted measures. But of course what you can't control is a patient lying or under-reporting or over-reporting. So at the end this is where the dynamics are important of the data. And this is actually where, if you link with the healthcare provider, this data will be much more increased in quality because you have this input from the physician side.
How are you dealing with some of the HIPAA requirements or equivalent, for example, European health data issues, given that you're soliciting personal identifiable health information and then sharing it with various third parties in a social environment?
Yeah, so this, the question is, at the end, are you HIPAA compliant and how do you deal with the issues if you share data? Now, what is very important, we are an anonymous site, so we don't force users to give their identities. There's also the way how do you store the data, who has access to this data. So, of course, we meet these requirements on the European side. There's kind of a privacy commission, similar to the HIPAA here, actually, in the States, where you have to go through all these different points, and these are all met. So this is very important, especially when we link with the healthcare provider. This becomes an issue because there's also responsibility here as well.
That was my next question. Yeah. What are the liability issues on behalf of the healthcare provider when the person reports a symptom or something?
So this is why, for example, here in the US, the hospital that we're now dealing with, it's the responsibility of the patient to get this information and upload this, and it's there. If he wants to give this to the physician, they have to print it. It's their action. Okay. Like this, actually, you bypass this. The platform that we're developing for this Belgian hospital, there's actually a direct access from the physician.
So then how does that...
Actually, that's all the time we have, but Mitch, you'll stick around until the end?
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic.
Okay, thank you.
Round of applause.